you would have us to do. The right thing for every citizen, every section, and every service in this city of Hartsville. Father, we thank you for your divine protection, because there is evil in this world. And we ask you to move on the hearts and minds of the people as only you can do, Lord. And we thank you for your protection. Father, now we ask all these blessings in the name of our Son Jesus Christ, whom we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to start off with a surprise. We have a very special guest in the audience tonight, and former Councilwoman Adelina Graham has just celebrated a 91st birthday. Ms. Graham, if you would join us at the front.
Come on.
Everyone, we want you all to know that Ms. Adelina Graham, who served on City Council for 24 years, is that correct?
Yes.
For 24 years, is celebrating her 91st birthday on June 19th. And so on behalf of the City of Hartsville and all of the citizens, I'm sure that they wish you well. We want to wish you a happy birthday.
Thank you.
Thank you.
sorry. I forgot the oath of office. If you would wait just a minute. It was just a preview. I want to keep you appraised.
Skipper, do you want to explain what's going on?
I'm happy to. It's my honor and my pleasure to swear in your next city clerk for the city of Hartsville. She took over yesterday, and this is her first official city council meeting and my last official city council meeting. So it's been a ride. It's been fun, but I am so honored to swear somebody in who is of the caliber that she is. She is going to do you an outstanding job. Mayor, council, you will be made proud. There's no doubt about it. And this is her daughter, Macy, and she's going to hold the Bible that Andrew's going to place her hand on and swear to do y'all a good job.
Sharon doesn't need to cry before it.
Swearing on.
I do solemnly swear.
I do solemnly swear.
That I am duly qualified.
That I am duly qualified.
According to the Constitution of this state.
According to the Constitution of this state.
To exercise the duties.
To exercise the duties.
Of the office to which I have been appointed.
Of the office to which I have been appointed.
And that I will.
And that I will.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
Discharge the duties thereof.
Discharge the duties thereof.
Preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution.
Preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution.
Of this state and of the United States.
Of this state and of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
As city clerk of the municipality of Hartsville.
As clerk of the municipality of Hartsville.
I will equally, fairly, and impartially.
I will equally, fairly, and impartially.
To the best of my ability and skill.
To the best of my ability and skill.
Exercise the trust reposed in me.
Exercise the trust reposed in me.
And I will use my best endeavors.
And I will use my best endeavors.
To preserve peace and carry into effect.
To preserve peace and carry into effect.
According to the law, the purposes.
According to the law, the purposes.
For which I have been appointed.
For which I have been appointed.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Done and done.
Mayor likes to do that.
two-man-to-man fatherhood. Because whereas fathers play a vital role in the growth and development of children, and whereas Man-to-Man Fatherhood Initiative continues its mission to engage fathers in the positive support of their children and to enhance community support for fatherhood throughout the PD region. And whereas fathers fail to contribute to the financial and emotional well-being of their children, their absence can cause undue financial and emotional pressures on mothers. And whereas Man-to-Man Fatherhood Initiative is dedicated to promoting and strengthening the well-being of children through the emotional, social, and financial support of involved, responsible, and committed fathers. And whereas Man-to-Man Fatherhood Initiative's approach to strengthening fathers includes a comprehensive fatherhood program to teach the essentials of responsible fatherhood. Now therefore, I, Casey Hancock, Mayor of the City of Hartsville, do hereby proclaim the month of July 2023 as Responsible Fatherhood Month in Hartsville and encourage all of our citizens to join in commending Man-to-Man Fatherhood Initiative for their continuing work and contributions to support responsible fatherhood efforts. It is my honor. You do great work, and we appreciate all that you do.
Thank you.
My pleasure to be here.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Obviously, if you'd like to make a few words, your floor is yours.
Go ahead. Just want to say thank you for recognizing the work we do. We do continue to serve fathers. We have our staff in the back. Also, we brought, if they would stand, so everybody would know who they are, so you see them in the back. We even had some of our participants that we've served, they came to just to be a part. Had a few of them tonight. So. Now we are providing services at the Warren Charlton Tech building every Wednesdays at 3 o'clock that session start. We continue to help men be the best fathers. We realize families are the foundation for the community as well as the nation, so continue to help us support fathers and families. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. If you're not familiar with the work of Man to Man, if this is your first time hearing about it, I encourage you to do a quick Google. There's some remarkable individuals behind it, and they're delivering some impressive results. Very, very pleased to honor you tonight.
And are you on the Florence Darlington Technical site on 4th, I mean, I'm not 4th Street, but Swift Creek Road?
Yes.
Okay. What are your hours?
So we provide, here in Hartsville, we do the father's sessions, but we are open every day from 9 to 5, Mondays through Thursdays. We have an office in Florence, an office in Bakersfield. We are looking for an office here in Hartsville. That way men will have access to come and get services every day. So we're definitely looking forward to doing more here as well.
All right, thank you.
Next, it is my pleasure to deliver a proclamation for Parks and Rec Month. Anybody here, perhaps named Adam Bedard, would like to come forward? Okay, of course. Thank you both for being here tonight. Honored to have you. And ladies and gentlemen, if you don't understand how busy these two are, keeping not only Byerly Park in shape, but Neptune Island these last few days have been pretty busy. So the fact that you're awake in here already impresses me. So it's my pleasure to present this tonight for whereas parks and recreation programs are an integral part of communities throughout this country, including Hartsville, of course. And whereas our parks and recreation are vitally important to establishing and maintaining the quality of life in our communities, ensuring the health of all citizens, and contributing to the economic and environmental well-being of our community. And whereas our parks and natural recreation areas ensure the ecological beauty of our community and provide a place for children and adults to connect with nature and recreate outdoors. And whereas the U.S. House of Representatives has designated July as Parks and Recreation Month. The City of Hartsville, of course, recognizes it as well. Now, therefore, I, Casey Hancock, Mayor of the City of Hartsville, do hereby proclaim this month, the month of July 2023, as Parks and Recreation Month, and encourage all of our citizens to increase awareness of the importance of all areas of parks and recreation as fundamental to the well-being of our community. So it's my pleasure to present this to you both. Thank you so much for being here. How would you like to frame this? I should jump in the middle.
No, right in the middle, buddy.
Okay. to recognize General Aviation Month. If there's anyone here that might want to come forward to accept this proclamation, perhaps one of my favorite officers. Be the newest member of board.
Thank you, sir.
So glad to have you here. Mark, always a pleasure. Brandon. All right, ladies and gentlemen, these are the people who keep our airport running, in case you didn't know that. Whereas the Palmetto State is home to 6 commercial airports, 54 general aviation airports, and 4 very busy military airfields that provide essential support to South Carolina's diversified business base, increasing our population and growing our tourism industry. And whereas airports support assist South Carolina in many ways, including recreational flying, providing a gateway to communities and tourist attractions, accommodating agricultural spraying, supporting air cargo and air freight shipments, helping law enforcement, supporting the military in its operation, providing access in times of emergency, and supporting medical needs in the medical profession. And whereas the nation's aviation infrastructure represents a very important public benefit, and congressional oversight should be in place to ensure stable funding of this system. It makes me proud, therefore, that I, Casey Hancock, Mayor of the City of Hartsville, do hereby proclaim August 2023 is General Aviation Month. In the City of Hartsville, I encourage all of our citizens to recognize General Aviation for its significant contributions to our quality of life and economic growth and stability. And if you haven't visited lately, please make time to take a few minutes and visit the Hartsville Regional Airport and see the new terminal if you haven't seen it yet. These people have got a lot going on out there, Mark in particular, Brandon, Chairman of the Board. It's my honor to present this to you. Thanks for coming tonight.
Thank you.
All right, thanks again, y'all.
Thank you.
Keep up the good work.
Hartsville International is open for business.
Yes. Hashtag. Well, I'm going to read this whole thing, so get ready. I hope you brought snacks. That's what's important. Because whereas Sharon L. Skipper has a long history as a public servant since she began her service to the citizens of Hartsville on October 7, 1980, and will continue to serve the public in a new role, thank goodness. And whereas Sharon has served in many capacities during her 43 years of employment with the City of Hartsville, but has found her true calling when she took on the role of city clerk in 1998. And whereas Sharon served as city clerk under 7 mayors, she dealt with 7 of us, including the historic first female and first African-American mayors, and 21 council members, coordinated 18 elections, and contributed to Hartsville's 2 All-America City Awards, awarded 20 years apart. And whereas the city clerk for 35 years, Sharon has provided exemplary service in her vital role as the link between the citizens and city council, historian, and go-to source of information. And whereas during Sharon's service as city clerk, she has been a mentor and trusted guide to all who positively influenced professional careers and lives of city clerks across the state and region. Elected officials, of course, myself included, and leaders under whom she served. And whereas her faith, integrity, calm in the face of adversity, wise guidance, and sense of humor has earned the respect and love of those who are blessed to work beside her. And whereas Sharon Skipper has received awards too numerous to list, but tonight she receives the accolades and appreciation of the mayors and council members whom she served for all these years. So I am proud, therefore, as Casey Hancock, Mayor of the City of Hartsville, South Carolina, to proclaim the week of July 10th, 2023 as Sharon L. Skipper Week. In honor of her long-standing love, service, and devotion to the City of Hartsville, and its citizens, during her 35 years of service as city clerk, it is my absolute honor you, and I think I speak on behalf of the rest of our council as well. Thank you for joining us here. It's been a pleasure, but we are glad we will keep seeing you around. So much. Thank you very much. So we can hug instead of shake hands now? And now that you're free to speak, I'm sure you have plenty to say. About 7 mayors and 20 some odd council members.
Read my book.
Thank you so much. But as I, yeah, please come in. As I said, Sharon may be stepping down as city clerk. Y'all, yeah, please come forward. She's not leaving the city altogether just yet, and we're so, so glad.
She's going to be the new special projects director. So she'll be working alongside myself, which I'm excited about. So I'm very happy.
My family gets me
back.
Talking
first, it's right.
Come on, get on.
Put up with me.
But this is my granddaughter Madison, my grandson Bentley, my grandson on the end, Dalton, and his new fiance Kaylee. He's growing. Don't hear me talk about Ron. This is Ron. Dalton was it.
If I could say just one thing, she has served the city well. And she does it by putting God first.
That's right.
You put him first, you can make it through anything. And she worked half time at the city and at the hospital with me. And there were so many times that I was gone, I couldn't figure out why they brought me back. And she told me she was praying the whole time.
Oh, wow.
I love her. I've asked for permission for you to be dismissed. We can just not sit down and go on now.
Just get out of here.
Just get out of here. Get out of here, Mom.
That's what he told me when I asked him earlier.
Yes, sir.
Go
both
for
yes, sir.
All the other staff stay.
Got it. Y'all got to stay.
You've been here for 4 years.
Just one thing, if you would, I know you wrote it down, but please read your address for the record. State your name and address for the record and keep your comments to 2 minutes.
Yep, Vincent Gattings at 301 River Bridge Lane, Hartsville, South Carolina. So just one big riff I have is the shooting grounds. about 3 years now. We've been complaining. And keep getting told that it's a private street. Well, who owns a private street? We don't know. Well, who knows? Not really worried about it. Okay, so who is worried about it? Well, everyone that lives on River Birch Lane and do something, because you have to drive down it. Currently, right now, there's 13 potholes on a 20th of a mile. It's 2 blocks. Now, who else drives on that private road, supposedly? The city? The federal government? The ML? So is it so private? No, it's not. I just want to know, with resolutions to these problems, how is it going to be addressed? And then who, with the budget, who addresses the budget? How's it coming back? Because apparently we have $860,495 for fiscal year 2023. That's just one of the answers.
Well, thank you for your comments. Thanks for bringing that to the council's attention. And we got your phone number. We'll follow up with you. As you said yourself, it is a private road, so the city can't do much, but we may be able to help, if nothing else, advocate on your behalf to work towards a resolution. So we'll follow up with you, me and the city manager and I, rather. But thanks for coming here.
And I sympathize. I live on a private road.
Okay.
I've patched the potholes in front of my yard and down the street.
So I guess my question is, how does a road become private?
It starts off private and never is transferred to either the city, county, or state system.
Okay.
Usually by a developer.
Because Hartsville's like, hey, you know, it's private. We don't want to help. County's like, hey, it's private. It's private. We don't want to help. It's like,
and of course, you know, I would love if they would help, but you can't spend public money on private property, which is basically where we are.
Okay. And with a private road, does someone pay taxes? Or
It's really hard on the tax assessor site. You can go to the Dalton County Tax Assessor site, which shows you who owns all the property. The roads are not included in that. I don't know why. And so it would probably take some title work by somebody to figure out who owns it.
Okay. Because who owns it, Travis?
What's that?
Who owns it?
Yeah, I have her name written down. So
and nobody knows?
Which name would be given that?
No one's getting contacted.
And I'm not a lawyer. I don't know the rights and the responsibilities of somebody who owns a private road. I'm sure, you know, there's something there, but you know, whether they have to maintain it or not, I'm unsure.
I appreciate your 2 minutes.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you
for being here. We're moving on to the manager's update. Mr. Manager, what do you have for us?
Yes, sir. I just have a few short items for you. Just, again, a reminder of Municipal Association annual meeting for those that signed up. It's going to be July 27th and 30th, so please join the other cities and their councils as they get updates on what's going on throughout the state for their legislative actions. And there's going to be a Duke Energy Municipal Mingle. We'll get that information to you guys. Another quick thing is that, speaking of the airport, we already have an airport terminal naming ceremony. As you recall, we dedicated that to Senator Jared Floyd. We are working on that currently. And we'll let you guys know as soon as the federal and state can reach out for a schedule and see. Another point of order information, election is coming up for districts 2, 4, and 6. Just want to remind everyone, filing opens up August 1st through the 15th. We have been advertising in the Messenger on June 28th, and also there will be one going out August 2nd as well. But please, if you're going to, please go ahead and put your names in the hat for the election. And then lastly, I wanted to bring up that we're going to be talking about this August 1st for our work session. The short-term rentals, that was brought up to the Planning Commission, and as I stated in the email that I sent to you guys, there is some conversation going around about what exactly they want to do. I don't to talk about it tonight, but I want to give you a heads up that we already start talking about whether or not we'll put some regulations on short-term rentals, or just identify them, or see what role the city wants to play in that. I'm going to be sending out a short-term rental model ordinance that's provided by the Municipal Association. Please take a look at it, let you know, but we'll be providing some feedback on that as well. Okay, any questions about any of those things?
Is there another city that has a short-term rental?
There's many.
That we've looked at?
Yes, ma'am. There's many, and a lot of them have adopted a version of this model ordinance in the Municipal Association. It's kind of a pick-and-choose type situation. The real situation that's going on is that some cities are trying to become more restrictive on short-term rentals and figure out how to do those. Those are Airbnbs and Vrbos. But it's really up to the city what they want to do until the state makes a decision. But I will be looking at it.
Thank you.
And that's all I have.
Thanks, sir. Any other questions for me?
Okay. Consent agenda, moving right along. That brings us to new business. We missed the 20-minute mark, Councilman McGee, but I think we can make some progress from here. Resolution 072301, Mr. Manager, if you would publish it, title of presentation.
Yes, sir. It's approval to apply for the South Carolina Parks Recreation and Tourism SCPRT grant.
Is there any, I have a motion.
Manager, tell the city, I mean, it's a wonderful opportunity.
Absolutely. So, yes, sir. So what we're doing is in the fiscal, the next budget the city council approved in June, there actually is $400,000 set aside to rehab our water, the splash pad for our water park. A lot of you might not recall, but it's 10 years old. It was originally started as Pirateville, and so it needs some love and some TLC. The main goal with this is that we found an opportunity to apply for up to $200,000 through South Carolina Department of Tourism, and we're going to be going after that to help fund 50% of the project. The overall goal with the splash pad, of course, is to enhance and increase safety, but also to make it more all-inclusive for everyone. So kids who are, have any type of disability or whatnot, be able to play with anyone who's there. And also kind of further increasing into the park and making it all part of Neptune Islands to start out differently. So our staff is constantly looking for opportunities for grants, and this just happens to be one of them. So we're very excited to go forward.
Love to hear it. Thank you for the explanation. Thank you for the point. Mr. McGee, do I have a motion to approve Resolution 072301?
So moved.
Second. I have a motion and a second. Any comment? This resolution, if not, I'll hear a vote. All those in favor of approving Resolution 072301, please indicate so by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The ayes have it. Resolution 072301 is approved. Moving on to Resolution 072302, Mr. Manager, if you would publish it for the record by title of presentation.
Yes, sir. It's approval of the City of Hartsville's letter of support for the South Carolina Governor's School for Science and Mathematics, GSSM, acquisition of adjacent property for growth and program expansion.
And then again, if you would explain.
Absolutely. So the Governor's School is looking to do some expansion, and we're very excited to have that happen. They are currently acquiring some properties around it as they come up. The foundation has purchased this in order for it to come off the tax books. It needs a letter of recommendation from the city and I guess other entities as well to support that and be removed from the tax books. But it is part of expansion of our wonderful Governor's School for Science and Math with all those little geniuses in there. So we're very excited about the opportunity.
Thank you. I would hear a motion to approve Resolution 072302.
So moved.
Have some motions. Any comment on this resolution? Questions? Hearing none, I'll entertain a vote. All those in favor of approving Resolution 072302, please indicate so by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The ayes have it. Resolution 072302 has been approved. And moving on to item 8, Resolution 072303. Mr. Manager, if you would publish it by title and presentation.
Yes, sir. It's Resolution 072303 to approve the bid award for cemetery operations and maintenance. We have two cemeteries. We'd like to maintain them.
We need to maintain them.
Yes. By contract.
By contract. do I have a motion to approve Resolution 072303?
Mr. Mayor, I so move that we approve Resolution 07-23-03.
Second. All right, there it is. I got a motion, second. Thank you, gentlemen. Any discussion on this motion to approve?
McGee, read the cemetery to me.
Yeah, I got a question. Now, we're only talking about two cemeteries, right? Greenlawn and or not the Marion Street Cemetery.
No, the Marion Street Cemetery is no longer active. So these are our two active cemeteries, Magnolia and Greenlawn.
Okay.
Right. They're on record perpetual care as well. So we have to do certain things by law.
All right. Thank you for your point of clarification. Anything else on this before we take a vote? All right. All those in favor of approving Resolution 072303, please indicate so by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Ladies and gentlemen, the ayes have it. Resolution 072303 is approved. And moving on to our not quite final item, item 9, Resolution 072304. Mr. Manager, if you would publish it by title and presentation, go ahead.
Yes, sir. It's to approve the bid award for water, wastewater, and plant operations and maintenance. And this one's a little more detailed, but it is essentially we have a wastewater treatment plant that manages 3 million gallons of sewage per day. And so we are looking to put this contract back up for bid, and we're looking to award it to U.S. Water. We've been working with the same company since 1985, so if Sharon were here, she could remember when we first started. She's not here, so I have to tease her. It's okay. But basically, we wanted to make sure that we were getting the best deal, and so we moved forward with the sealed bid process, and we are moving forward with selection for U.S. Water.
three under your consideration. Okay, thank you very much. I would entertain a motion to approve resolution 072304.
Mr. Mayor, I make a motion that we approve resolution 07-23-04.
Thank you, Councilman Mack.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion on this resolution?
Mr. Manager, what's the length of time for this contract?
This contract will be for 3 years. We have done it for, you know, every year renewed. This year we decided to go for a 3-year recommendation. It is going to be billed annually though.
And the reason that we're approving the 858,420 is because that's in this fiscal year. It's 3 years of 858.
Yes, exactly. Yes, sir.
$2.5 million altogether, but in this budget year, the 858 is what gets spent.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for the clarification. Anything else? All right, hearing none, I'll entertain a vote. All those in favor of approving resolution 072304, please indicate so by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The ayes have it. Resolution 072304 has been approved. And our last item of business, a first reading of ordinance 4456. Mr. Manager, if you would publish it for the record by title and presentation.
Yes, sir. It's an ordinance amending and restating certain provisions of the City of Hartsville Code within Chapter 2, Article 4, Division 4, Section 2-376 for Parks Committee.
Okay. Quick explanation for
yes, sir. The Parks and Recreation Committee, or Parks Committee, rather, came to the City Council and requested that their scope be expanded to look at more recreational activities outside of just parks, which is really just Byerly Park for them. So they made a presentation, and now it's going to be, if we do approve this, it's going to be the Parks and Recreation Advisory Committee, which will report again to you guys for recreational activities throughout the entire city. We do appreciate everything they do. Of course, this is a volunteer committee, and we are excited they want to bring more ideas to us.
And this came to us from the committee itself.
From the committee itself.
Yes. Very cool.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Mayor, I would just add, as the liaison to that committee, as the manager said, it came through a very engaged and involved group of volunteers. So on that committee, we just said we'd like to do more. We'd love to give input in this advisory. That's all we're saying. But they love where our parks are, and they just find ways to create other opportunities and recreations.
And that's awesome.
It just makes good sense. And yes. Tony was the Ritter, who was the chair of that.
To approve the first reading of ordinance 4456. I have a motion and a second. Any further? I have some motions and some seconds. Anybody got that? Oh, she's got it. Any further discussion on this?
There's a scribbler's error that I notified the city clerk about, and she'll take care of that.
All right. Thank you. Eagle eyes over there. All right. Yeah, I would like to remind all of our guests that the Chamber of Commerce, Ms. Murphy Monk is here tonight, is hosting a Connection After Hours and Open House at our beautiful Center Theater. That's at 214 North 5th Street. That is July 13th at 5:30. I would encourage everyone who is able to attend and check out what they've got going on at the Center Theater. It's an absolutely incredible gem for our downtown. So thank you, Murphy, for hosting this, and I hope to see you there. See, you threw me off, man.
I got texted. So
okay, back to that. We have a motion and a second. I would entertain a vote to approve the first reading of ordinance 4456. All those in favor, please indicate so by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The ayes have it. First reading is approved. And now, everyone, please be aware. All right. Everything else is information only. It was not 20 minutes, but we are under the limit for the All-Star game. And hearing no objection, ladies